We started from scratch in the year 2000. That means Ruud Schmidheiny, who is the owner, and myself as the curator. And we had the idea to look for contemporary Latin American art. The underlying background was that we knew that Latin America is a very rich continent, art-wise, cultural-wise. And that's why we knew from the beginning that it would be worth it. So we started traveling lots everywhere, listening to everybody, informing ourselves, and trying to make connections between the different persons, the cities, the countries, etc. And during this process, it was quite easy to buy, to make acquisitions, because at the time, 15 years almost ago, nobody really was interested into Latin American art. So people even declared us to be quite crazy to want to discover this terrain. And so that was the start. It went quite well. Now we do have like 1,100 works by roughly 110 artists. But another issue from the beginning was that we wanted to bring the art back to Latin America. And that's why we went as well looking for venues, for cities, and for buildings. And so we were happy and glad to find a beautiful old colonial building in Rio de Janeiro. That was in the year 2005. Took 1 year only the acquisition. Brazil is very bureaucratic, it's amazing. And it took us another 5 to 6 years to restore the building and to implement our collection there. So what we are having now is a platform in Rio de Janeiro called Casa Dados, where we show parts of the collection. What we show there are two major big exhibitions every year, which come from our collection. And around, as a satellite program, we have many, many events, roundtables, etc., on all levels, from the university to the favela. So the idea is to create a platform in Latin America for the exchange of Latin American art, and also to offer this platform to all the players, to the artists, to the collectors, to the critics, etc., to the whole world. The collection is not encyclopedic. We have never been aiming at that. It's impossible, anyway. What we are wanting is to include only works of a certain quality, whatever quality, of course, means and might be. But that means also works which have not been done similarly in another context before, for example. We do not have folkloristic works, but maybe somebody might imagine about Latin America. This is not the case. It's really international art, what we are collecting. And I want the artwork to be able to speak to any audience in any future and any place of this world. So that means I don't want to integrate anecdotal things which need a 10-page explanation. So it's just my criteria I used to apply before in my former life as an art historian and a curator. Of course, I adapted myself and I learned much more about Latin America, surely. But the main criteria always remain the same. If you take this exhibition, you will find, I think, Cildo Meirelles' installation, Missões, Brazilian artist. This is very Latin American. You could not easily find it anywhere else. But mostly, those artworks could have been generated anywhere. So they are really, of course, you have a certain background, a personal background, but this background you find anywhere and everywhere in the arts, always. And of course, you can also find a cultural background, but you would not assume to find out about that if you look at the work as a formal thing. You could not say, this is Latin America, this is Asian, not anymore. What we wanted to do is to offer an amuse-bouche, I would call it like that, like a starter, like an aperitif, just to give a little glimpse into our collection, because what you see here is, numerically speaking, like 1.5% of the collection. Honestly and definitely, I love all the pieces, the 1,100 works in the collection, because of course, after all, you feel that they are your babies in a way. No, I don't have any special appreciation. I'm sure, from my point of view, that all those works are on the same artistic level.